What's up, everybody? A Sparrow with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on Subnautica. Now, as most of you are probably aware, there was an update yesterday that came out, and it was really cool and exciting, and there's some neat stuff, things that we've long waited for. But you might notice, curious, we're still in the old base. How did this happen? But if you look at the build number on the right, we're on the update. How did that happen? I don't know. It's magic. No, actually, it was because one of my subscribers sent me a comment a couple episodes ago to a link to another person's video on how to basically keep your base safe when you update the game. So we have all the same stuff, which is awesome. Basically, the short version, if I remember, if not, somebody leave a comment, remind me, because I will more than likely forget, but I will try and remember to put the link in the description of at least this video so that, you know, other players that watch my stuff and things can do that as well. Because it's no fun. It's no fun starting over. I've done it a bunch of times and it just gets really, really, really old. So, basically, short version, though, is anyone familiar with the chunk-type system like Minecraft or basically any kind of grid-based map? Basically, what you do is you go through and you clear out your map files, all of your data, in the save game file. Then you walk through here with, what is it, F1? And under the camera batch number, it kind of gives you your coordinates for the grid you're in. And you basically write down any grids that your base is occupying, and then you delete everything but those in your save game file, and you go into another file and you change the build number so it uses the more recent build number. And then when you actually save it and upload and, update and, you know, load the game with the new build number with no map data except your bases, it reloads all of the map that you're missing with the new build, but because it already has existing data for your base, it doesn't delete it. That's the shortest explanation for really what you're doing. So yeah, super duper excited. Now, on to the matter at hand, which is, we have new stuff to find. The biggest things, I think, there is the bed, which is awesome. It's a cool idea, and we're totally gonna have to make a captain's cabin complete with decorations and crap. But maybe we'll do one like right above here. Can we do that? Is there anything above this? No, maybe we could go like two up, or maybe, what would one, let's see what one would look like. If I went up one, that might be enough for like a captain's cabin type thing. That would be kind of cool. But basically, the only reason I'm not more excited about like the bed thing is I read on the wiki somewhere that it's intended to improve. Oh, by the way, while I finish this conversation, we're going to head out to the bloodgrass area. I call it that. I don't know. It's actually called, like, the Grass Plateau or something, but we're gonna go out to the Bloodgrass area and also to the Mushroom biome, because those are the two areas where, if all this update stuff worked, we should get new fragments for the two chargers that I'm looking for, which is the new battery charger and cell charger, or power cell charger, which is awesome! So while we're doing that, I'm gonna go over some other stiffs. So, if I can actually find where I'm going, right? Remember where I'm at. So the bed is a cool idea, but because it doesn't actually speed up the night cycle at the moment, which is what it's eventually intended to do, it's not really worth the effort going to look for it specifically until we're just bored and there's nothing better to do. But whereas like the chairs and some of the other things are actually useful because they'll basically be doing like the chair either minimizes or something to where you don't lose any of your hunger and water while you're just sitting there. Things like that. So I know they have plans for the bed to speed up the night cycle, but because it doesn't right now, I'm not in a super big rush to find one. But the other big things is the chargers for both power cells and batteries now, which is awesome. Get out of my way. Be gone. For example, see, this is good proof that the whole map thing works. That we did change the map. Ooh, excuse me. We did change the map, but we still have new fragments, which proves the point. So there may be a little bit more texture pop-in loading at the moment, because it's basically redoing everything. Once you've been to places before, it basically just has to reload stuff that it already generated, but right now it's probably redoing all the terrain generation, so bear that in mind if it's it's a little stuttery at the moment. Is this salt? What is this? That just seemed like a really big salt deposit. Couple other things that the update did, they added new models. Boom! Battery. We can charge our batteries, we can charge our batteries, oh-dee-doo-da-day. You know, sometimes I just feel like I need to take a break and, recharge my batteries. No? Okay. So the bloodgrass area has the battery charger. The mushroom biome, however, is one of the areas you can get the power cell charger from, so we're gonna head that way. Now, there is another place you can get them? I think it was... I wanna say... Don't quote me on this, but I wanna say it was... In the... Dude, these bone sharks are like uber aggressive today. Get out of here. I'm just gonna do another pulse just to make sure they're getting away from me. Bam! Perimeter defense combined with solar charger. Awesome. I think I've been in this one already. I just want to double check and make sure there isn't anything new. Like, get... Wait, really? Am I that fat? I can't get through there? What is this? Is this a PDA? Oh! Abandoned PDA. Huh. What do you know? Okay. I don't see anything. I still haven't made a freaking rebreather yet.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
I don't see anything in there. We're gonna zip on out of here. Assuming I don't get stuck in this on my way out. Some of the other things, though, that are pretty neat were not even, like, item-related. It was more... Let's actually head more towards the Aurora, because that's a little easier to find the mushroom biome. Whoa! Where'd I go? Oh, wow. I'm in the complete wrong direction. But some things were like, they've added a new... I don't know, I didn't look up to find out where they're located, but they added a new type of creature called a sea trader. And at first I was like, wait, what? We're gonna just... Are we Dr. Doolittling this and talking to the fish now? But apparently they either drop stuff or... I know the article did, or the update newsletter thing did say you can use their poop for the bioreactor, which I was like, okay. I mean, it makes sense, it was just like, that's random. I think it'd be funny, though, if you could find either, like, an egg or find a means to capture them type of thing. Because then you could, like, basically have a poop farm for your bioreactor, which would just be hilarious. Let's see, what else did they do, though? It lets you, like, they randomly spawn or drop blocks. Not blocks. Rock-type things. Rock formations that... I'm assuming it's kind of like the limestone, sandstone stuff. Like, they drop deposits, and then you can crack them open and get materials from them. So, that's an interesting new mechanic that basically there's some form of method that... basically makes certain resources renewable. Oh my! Oh my, that is the scariest silhouette I have ever seen in my life. Good gravy. I have suddenly developed an urge to take the long way around to the mushroom biome. Not really sure what contributed to that, but, you know, just have one of those feelings. Like I should totally go the longest way possible to get there. Jeez. Give me a heart attack over here. Is there no place that's safe? Seriously though, that's the first time I've seen them out in this area. Normally they're further up towards the nose. Is that still him swimming around? I'm paranoid now. Is that Bubbles or is that him? Alright, let's just get to scan it and get out of here. I thought I saw... There it is. I knew I saw one. Let's see if you're... Yep! Power saw... Oh, man. That was just my fins. Just my fins. Seriously. Shadows are scaring me now. Oh, man. I'm, like, for real paranoid right now. Oh, that was scary. Good grief. Scan, please. Okay, there's two. I'm liking that I'm not having to go to the ends of the earth to find some of this stuff. I did also read that the wreck, or not the wreck, the bed can be found... Where did it say... Oh, I'm not watching my ear at all.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Speak of the devil. The bed can be found, I think it was in the wreck in the mountains by the crash up here. So, I forget how to get there. I think it's like following the nose of the ship or something like that. But it's apparently in the mountain zone. There's a wreck by the crash zone that you can find the bed in, but I don't know if you need a diamond cutter or anything like that. I did not read super duper into it. I admittedly, like, it's not something that I don't want to go find. It's just when it was power chargers or power cell or battery chargers over something that they, you know, the wiki said doesn't really even speed up the... nighttime like it's supposed to yet. It was kind of like, yeah, we'll save that. I want to go get the chargers. They're the big thing for me. There's other stuff like the traders is huge. That's a big step for the game to have some kind of new essentially ecosystem or what do they call it? Like a subsystem, microsystem, whatever. One of those things that contributes to the environment feel of the game. That, you know, it's actually going to do something different. Where now some things that may or may not have been renewable will be. You could, if you find one, you know, you could build a... I don't know how they work in terms of migration and stuff. I don't know if they stay in the same spot, if they're... restricted to a certain biome, if they just wander around everywhere. I'm not really sure what the mechanics are for them. I just know that they said that in some capacity, I don't know if you have to give them anything or whatever, but they just kind of, they're a means through some method to spawn more stuff. Which I was like, that's pretty cool, because we've talked about that before, of what happens when you mine all of the resources in your area kind of thing. Now, I think, I'm not 100% sure about this, but I think...
Welcome aboard, Captain.
I think that I have what I need to make the chargers already. What is it that... They weren't too fancy. Two titanium, one glass, which is two quartz, a copper wire, and computer chip, and I totally was in the... bloodgrass area and ran right off without looking for silver. Dagnabbit. I knew there was something I was forgetting. And I don't think I have any extra silver on me at the moment. We have gold, mercury, lead. We definitely have the copper. We're gonna make a couple of these wires real quick. But I definitely do not have the silver. Oh, it takes two ore now. That's new. Is it? I think that's new. I always thought it was one. Maybe wire isn't... Maybe that isn't different. I thought it was. I feel like I had a electronics. There we go. Let's just throw that. Did this? Oh, okay. That's weird. Apparently I missed a letter on that. Who knew? So we definitely have the titanium. We definitely have the quartz. We're gonna go ahead and make the glass out of that real quick just so that it's there. Okay, and let's put titanium in there. All right, so we have the it's basically the computer chip then that we're really missing. Yeah, and I'd like to make one of each, at least for the main base, and then we can work with it in at length for, like, the Cyclops and stuff. Now, one interesting thing, we do have new models for the solar panel, which look awesome and totally fit the art style, go figure. These do say 66%, but the sun is going down, but I noticed they're facing the wrong way, so I'm guessing... I don't think this is so much a bug. I think it's just that when they built the models, they must have flipped a plane somewhere, and now they're facing a different direction. So, we're gonna break these so that we can replace them. And... ooh, okay, this is new. This is actually much better, though, because remember they were sideways before, so now that they've flipped them... it would be kind of cool if they were facing the other way, or if you could flip them around, like, other blocks, though. That would be a nice improvement. Though this is pretty handy. Yeah, I know, I still can't get rid of that one. I was, for a second, that took me a minute. I was like, wait, what? What is that other platform doing there? So that's kind of cool, because we can get a much more precise placement for these. Now, here's an interesting comparison. So this says 51, and this says 51. So technically, if you've had your solar panels placed, this is a cosmetic fix then. Now, there is another interesting thing. I'm missing solar panels. I just realized this. Oops. I just realized that I had 5 or 6 up here, and now I only have 3. I thought, anyway, I could be mistaken. It's not like that has never happened before. I mean, only all the time. But I really thought I had more than 3 up here. I mean, it's not like I don't have the materials to make more or anything. We've got plenty of quartz and titanium. So I tell you what, I'm gonna keep fixing these and maybe add a few more just to give us some extra power. I do like this, though. The placement is way easier in terms of precision. I say this as I put one in a really weird spot. But anyways, I'm gonna keep fixing this, and then I'm probably gonna go look for some silver and get what else we need to make, the chargers, because I want to test those out, even though all of my stuff is charged. I can fix that, you know. But I'd like to see how it works a little bit. So we're going to test that out. So I will be back in a moment. Okay, so I've arrived back at the base. And I've got a couple of things going. I used the propulsion cannon to pick up some stuff so that we could get a battery drained. Or used. And then I pulled the solar charger out of the sea glimpse. So that we could test out the power cell thing. Now, this says 86% charge, so left mouse button. Oh, this is a new menu. Okay. Oh, wait a minute. Let me refill my air. And I don't want to park it in the moon pool room because then the solar panels will charge it. So, I'm out here at the moment. Previous mouse, SNA, next, move, left mouse button to select... or E. Okay, so... okay, unload power cell. Okay, and then it gives you one. Oh, that's cool! Okay. Welcome. Now, how does this work, though? With the batteries... oh, okay, you hit R. R is like the button you used to use to throw a new battery in, but now it gives you the option to unload the battery, and now it won't use anything. And then I have one in my inventory. Oh, that's so cool! Okay. Alrighty. Oh, and we have one here as well. So we have a 91 and a 97, so we can unload those. Oh, that's actually neat too. That means you could switch power sources. That's so cool. Alright, now we're cranking. Okay, so what do we need? I have 4 quartz. 2 of them are going to go to the computer chips. We don't need... Oh, wait a minute. I don't need quartz, I need glass for those. So I can put those in there. We got 2 silver. I think I might need more coral. Yeah, it's 2 coral. Okay, darn it. So we got 1 computer chip anyway. I've almost used up some of the coral out here. No, I guess there's more. I was thinking I used up most of it, but I guess I didn't. Okay. So. We got that. Computer chip. I'm gonna need 2 more titanium, I guess. I have a scrap metal thing in my inventory, that's funny. Okay, and we don't need the copper, the salt, or the gold. I was just thinking, where did my silver go? Yeah, Okay, that's power appliances. Oh, I need the wire. Where did I put the wire? That's in electronics. There we go. And I have a 100% charge battery there, for reasons unknown. So, battery charger... Let's just put it on this wall, and then we'll put the power cell next to it. Power cell charger we'll put over here. And then maybe we could put a... Let's see if this would work. I'm not going to build it right now, but let's just see if I could put a locker... I could put a locker in between them that's like for power sources, which would be kind of cool. Alright, so access battery charger. And then left mouse button to equip... Oh, it's so cool! It tells you on the display thing, too, how charged they are. And then it's pulling from the power source. You can see 399 of 400. So we can totally run 2 of these without a problem. Let's check power cells. So you can do 2 power cells. This is freaking awesome. Now, there is one issue with this. And, well, it's not really an issue. It's more of a... mechanical how would you properly set this up thing, because I saw in their update video the power cell charger being on the Cyclops, which is cool because you think, oh, I could charge my own power cells, but unless it requires less power to charge it than it does to output, you know, like half of a power cell charges a full power cell or something, which I don't see that happening, that's kind of odd, then you're kind of left with, that would just be an infinite loop, you'd never charge anything, you'd just be trading power from one cell to another. But this is neat that you can have a power cell charger at your base, and when the Cyclops gets low, you can come back and finally charge it, you don't have to just keep crafting more of them, which is awesome, because I hated that. Anybody that's watched, well, my Subnautica series or my any of my Minecraft series long enough knows I hate things I can't just keep renewing or stuff. I hate stuff I have to make more of. So, now we can do this. Throw one in there. Throw it in there. So, the swim charge fins are gonna end up being more of an emergency thing then, I guess, because that's pretty awesome. That is pretty awesome. And I did beef up my solar panel array a little bit. I found out with these new models, it's usually roughly, if I want them from edge to edge, it's about 4. You couldn't put like a 5th one over here. So rows of 4. Now how many? I don't know. One thing I was trying to see too. No, I can't see it from down here. I was also trying to see if you put them too close together, if they would still maintain enough power. Like, this says... Wow, this is actually gaining. Oh, we're in some kind of eclipse thing. It's not that the sun's setting, I guess. Is it? I don't know. It's like we're eclipsing, but it is... I don't know. That's weird. 58. So I think, unless I'm in the same collision box, which I very well could be... Because I'm not seeing anything. Yeah, so I don't know about that one. Eh, nope. I'm just going to assume they're normal, because they look fine. So I'm expecting them to be relatively the same, even though they're close together. How are you doing? So that was decent. That was 86 to 100%. So that didn't take too long, maybe a minute. Or something like that. Minute and a half. So that was pretty good. And then we can pull that back out. Let's go visit the sea moth. Park it back in the moon pool. Whee! Here, let me repair you while I'm at it, too. Okay, so no power source. Left click. That's so cool.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh, right. And access panel. Put you back in there. Now, this also means I may not need the solar charger and can possibly outfit the sea glimpse with something else. Because if it's here, it's going to charge from the solar panels or the base power. If we were in the Cyclops, it would be charging off the Cyclops power, and then the power cells can be charged off the base. So, technically, I could keep a solar charger or an extra power cell or something in this as a backup, but realistically, once we get a Cyclops, this is either going to be parked here or there, so I doubt I'd ever run out of power on that one. So I don't know that I'd really need the solar charger after we got to that point. So that's something that we'll have to look into, because that would be kind of interesting. But yeah, this is freaking awesome. Love it. Another couple of things that I forgot to mention. Oh yeah, I don't know what's going on here, by the way. I think I made a mistake and left. I don't think I should have put that many stalker eggs in here, because I think they're breeding. I didn't know they could do that. But I only put one of these sand sharks, and he's just chilling by himself. I put like three of these, and now they're everywhere. So yeah, I don't know about that. I think I might have messed that one up a little bit. Unless I just release them all into the wild at some point to get teeth somehow. I don't know. I don't know what to do about that. But, I mean, other than we could always let them out and kill them or whatever. But I don't think there's any more. There were eggs in here when I started this episode, and there isn't any more now. So I don't think there any more. But now that there's no more for sure... If I come back here in the next episode or something and there's more eggs, then we definitely know that these guys can breed and make more eggs. I always assumed the eggs were just spawned into the world. I didn't know if they were actually breeding them or not. One of the other things I forgot to mention in this update, though, for any of you torpedo fans out there that may not have been aware, is you can now... I don't know how to acquire them, but you can make gas torpedoes... Now, from gas pods, those there's one right there. Those big green guys that poop out gas, you know, they fart a lot. You can somehow, I don't know exactly how, I wasn't really super interested in it, so I don't really know for sure, but there's a way to harvest their gas pods that they release, and then you can basically use them to make gas torpedoes, which I was like, that's interesting. The one thing, I just looked at it, and I totally forgot to check. I wanted to see what else you needed to use to make it. So titanium. Titanium to make the vortex torpedoes, and then titanium and gas pods to make the gas ones. So, that's interesting. I don't really know what the gas does. I think it hurts you, so I don't know if you can actually use them to kill them. Because from my understanding, I've never used the torpedo system, but from my understanding, the vortex torpedoes don't kill things. They, like, stun them or something. But I don't think they actually kill them. So there's that. I don't think I'm missing anything. I probably am, but I don't think I'm missing anything from the new update. It was mostly the two chargers, the bed, the trade things, and the gas torpedoes. I think that's all that they really did. Which is a lot, don't get me wrong. Oh, and the solar panel models. I think that's it. I think that's what that's what this episode, this update was comprised of. I'm pretty sure. If I'm missing anything, my bad. We'll figure it out eventually. While I'm right here, before we wrap up this episode, let me just go ahead and take care of this so I don't forget. We're gonna put one right there. We're gonna call this power. I would put in, like, a power source or something, but if I can't fit, you know, anything more than electronic on the label, then I don't think I can put power source there. That wouldn't really work. So yeah, pretty freaking cool. So on that note, I think we're gonna wrap things up for this episode. I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. Peace.